One day after hearing from special counsel Robert Mueller on his investigation into Russian election interference, we now know what President Trump's response is. He spoke on a variety of topics today, but perhaps most aggressively about Mueller himself. Sinclair National correspondent Christine Frizzell brings us the latest.
There's no obstruction, there's no collusion, there's no nothing.
It was a familiar phrase, followed by a pivot, with President Trump personally attacking special counsel Robert Mueller, calling him, quote, totally conflicted.
He wanted to be the FBI director, and I said no. After he left the FBI, we had a business dispute. Not a nice one.
As for the claim Mueller wanted to be the FBI director, that was actually addressed in the Mueller report itself, with former Trump aide Steve Bannon recalling that the White House had invited Mueller to offer a perspective on the institution of the FBI, but that Mueller did not come in looking for the job, and that a business dispute at a Trump golf course did not rise to the level of a conflict, and claiming one was, quote, ridiculous and petty, according to Bannon. Still, the White House insisting the case is now closed.
And despite $40 million, 18 Trump haters, including people that work for Hillary Clinton and some of the worst human beings on earth, they got nothing. It's pretty amazing.
When Congress returns next week, Capitol Hill promises to be a staging ground for the impeachment debate, currently playing out in lawmakers' home districts and on the campaign trail.
These are impeachable offenses.
I mean, half of the president's 2016 campaign is in prison. His campaign chairman's in prison. Don't tell me there's not enough to debate impeachment.
Calls by House Democrats to move forward with impeachment proceedings against the president are increasing, though remain at less than 10% of the House, with those in leadership remaining firm they won't move forward with impeachment, at least for now. Instead, pleading for patience.
We want to do what is right and what gets results.
Christine Frizzell, CBS 2 News.
So let's go to our national question of the day. Who do you support if Congress opens impeachment hearings? Head to idahonews.com to vote. Hover over the news tab, top left corner of the screen, and then